It's me, Stormy, and here is your annual horoscope for the year 2020, and welcome to a brand new decade. Man, it is a year astrologically. We've got Saturn and Pluto coming together, Jupiter and Pluto coming together multiple times throughout the year, which is phenomenal because that's really useful to us. We've got the great conjunction of Jupiter and Saturn happening at the end of the year, bringing a turning point to the attention of all of us, from our global friends down to our personal lives. As well, 6 eclipses happening this year. Every planet that can will retrograde, and that includes your ruling planet taking its annual 3 times a year retrograde, which will be February, June, and October this year. Now, one thing I want to start out saying in the beginning of this video is I will cover the Mercury retrogrades in the monthly videos and in smaller videos, but you can go back to my 2019 Mercury retrograde in your element video and see what is going to be happening within your element, because it's still going to be in energies of water, so it will very much so apply in many of the same ways. And speaking of same ways, Virgos, as we're rolling into 2020, you are bringing forward some of the things you were working on and focused on all through 2019, especially things that have to do with your social groupings and friends, and things that have to do with self-expression, anything having to do with conception, whether that's children or children in your life in some way, shape, or form, or having children, conception of your own business ideas, your own joy, your own whatever it is. These are themes that you focused on in 2019 while the energies were on the Cancer and Capricorn axes. So this is a bit and big piece of your mental real estate for the last year plus, right? And as we come across into 2020, you are bringing those things with you. The difference is that they're coming forward in a different kind of form. At this point, It's continuing to have action, movement, and resolution. And it's a pretty big deal, because this has to do with how you're expanded and who you're connected with in the world. Virgo, has it been a year where you've been practicing trying to be friends or establish a new social circle in some way, shape, or form? What about your long-range plans and goals, right? And if it has anything to do with starting a business, having a baby, anything that has to do with adoption, or just taking a course that brings more joy and play and that childlike energy into your life, this will naturally change who you're connected to as well. So we're going to see that as soon as we walk into this year, as the themes continue, and we'll see them wrapping up about summertime, okay? So let's just jump in so I can tell you about it by date, so maybe the picture will make a little bit more sense. Right at the beginning of the year, January 10th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening at 20 degrees of Cancer. So this is that 11th house energy I was telling you about. You could find changes to your social group. This is a great time at the beginning of the year to sit down and have a little chat with yourself about what you want in your long-range goals and where you're at in the achievement of those things. You know, are you on track? Are you off par with what you've been trying to do? This is a wonderful time to take a look at that, but also to look at the organizations that you're connected with. You could see a change happening here for sure. On January 12th, Saturn and Pluto are gonna come together. And this is an interesting conjunction at 22 degrees of Capricorn, because it lights up your 5th house. So the first thing that I think of, and I'd like to point this out, is when Saturn and Pluto come together, this is a big deal, because it is a very slow but important evolutionary process that is happening for you. Pluto's been dying something off and allowing it to phoenix into something else, and Saturn will mature it. But what this energy comes with is some kind of loss, typically. But it's the kind of loss that immediately right behind it brings the gain with it as well, because it's the next best thing for you. So something that I think about when I'm looking at this 11th house lunar eclipse just 2 days before this conjunction that is a big astrological event for the year, is that this could be something connected to this new business. It could be something connected to taking on a new project, or something where you start to have some resolution. And I will tell you, because Saturn is going to move into Aquarius in March, and that will light up your 6th house zone. If you've had any problems with like an adoption or getting paperwork done, even for your own business, whatever it is that has been a piece of a process that has held you back in some way, shape, or form from achieving whatever this childlike expression is, this will be an energy that helps you. But I think you get to start to see a little bit of a a turnaround that happens right here January 12th in this particular area. So keep your eyes open for that and keep me posted down below about what's happening. March 22nd, Saturn will move into Aquarius, into your sixth house, but this is just a sneak peek. He's just here for a little snack, and then he's gonna retrograde and he'll be back in this sixth house from December 17th until 2023, okay? Now, when Saturn comes into a new area of your chart, what he's doing is he's trying to mature you. He's trying to take you to the next level. You get serious. You start to really take on some responsibility in your life here. Now, whether this is for daily routines, things about your work, maybe Saturn pops in here into Aquarius and you become really aware of things with your health or your body in some way, shape, or form. You can even become a little bit obsessive. We've just had Saturn-Pluto energy on the table just months earlier. You could be stirring a little bit of obsession or something going on here, but ultimately, in this energy, you're going to get very, very social to figure out what's happening in this day-to-day situation. The Aquarian energy will help you be social to figure out what's happening in your health. Now, I do think because Jupiter is also up here in this fifth house space until the end of the year, something that could be happening with Jupiter and Saturn in these two different areas is maybe you find out there's something wrong with a system of some sort that has held you back from starting that business. Or you find out that, you know, maybe you've had a health situation that you were unaware of, and now you're able to step into that and it continues to move some things forward for you. So that will ultimately be very useful energy for you. Now, Jupiter and Pluto are gonna come together April 4th, June 30th, and November 12th. We are here for these, Virgos. These are the big deal energies, right? Because they give you dramatic jump forward. It's like focused energy meets an opportunity and you are there, you're showing up and you're on it, right? This is the opportunity at these dates to take a very big leap forward because Jupiter expands you. Pluto has created a source of you that is regenerated and has an opportunity available to it. So these are focused, intense, like triple latte shot kind of energies. Take them and use them to expand things here in this fifth house area. Now, could this be that that business takes off or you get the idea or you have that opportunity and you hook up and you join a collaboration? Could this be that the adoption comes through? You know, something like that in this fifth house area, your area of joy or play. Do the kids get accepted into school? They're ready to start a new adventure. Whatever it is, that fifth house area will be lit up with like a triple shot of go get that when we get to these particular dates. May 25th, Venus is going to be retrograde in the energy of Gemini, a fellow Mercury-ruled energy, but this is at the tip-top of your chart, okay? With Venus retrograde, first thing we suggest is don't take on any new romance if you can avoid it. No big investments if you can avoid it. Because what happens is Venus comes out of retrograde and you just realize that it's not what you thought it was. Or there are things that are missing that are just not what you thought they were, right? But instead, what you can do is go back over this area. And with Venus there, you're like, is this area of my life in balance? Do I feel loved? Do I feel appreciated? Do I love what's happening here, right? And this is in your 10th house. So this is that career. You are re-looking at your career. You are re-looking at your connection to the work that you are doing. We've had this Cancer Capricorn axis, which has been giving you a fresh start, has been giving you the place where you can cultivate a new grouping of people, a new tribe that will help you make any transitions, even around career or things in your life that you need to make adjustments to. But this Venus retrograde is our first touchdown of 2020, which signals to you that also, as we get more forward in the year, you're going to really start to focus on work and home and what that balance is. And if you do not love what you're doing, or you feel like you're just unsatisfied, you need to change it in some way, shape, or form. This Venus retrograde is gonna help you go back over it. And I also think in the 10th house with Venus there, it's just really nice to go back over the solidity. Oh my goodness, I think I just made that word up. To go back over the solidarity of the relationships in your life, right? Are you in balance in your romantic and your financial connections? And if you're not, you'll get the chance to use this energy to make those adjustments. June 5th, we've got a lunar eclipse now happening in the energy of Sagittarius at 15 degrees. This lights up the 4th house. So now we've got that 10th house and 4th house axes that are lit up. You are making big changes starting right here in your home zone and in your career zone. Is this your relocation? Or are you planning on, you're evaluating the job right now, and as we get to the next Gemini Sagittarian energies at the end of the year, you're gonna be ready to locate. You know, did you get to adopt that baby? Did you get to have a baby? Are you pregnant now? Are the kids moving out? You're gonna help them do that situation. Oh, did you get the business started? Whatever it is, from 10 to 4 between work and home, you're gonna start making your changes right now as we land here in this June energy, okay? June 21st, we've got a solar eclipse happening in Cancer at 0 degrees, so that's back up in the 11th house. Then on July 5th, we've got a lunar eclipse happening in Capricorn at 13 degrees, that's back in the 5th house. And this is the last dance of the Cancer Capricorn axis, so changes to this social group, changes to this kid group, changes to your internal world about what these structures and balances are. This could bring new nurturing to your table. This could bring you in contact with a new tribe, absolutely, at that solar eclipse. And it could also find you with that fifth house lunar eclipse in the space to say, okay, is what I'm trying to do realistic, or is it time for me to put it down? Now, each of these eclipses are going to last you about 6 months worth of energy. So expect from that first one that we have in January all the way through the year, add 6 months to the energies that you're focusing on, and you'll be able to track those in your astrology journals or however you're tracking, okay? September 9th through November 13th, Mars is very comfortably going retrograde in the energy of Aries, which will light up your 8th house. Now, Mars is comfortable here because he rules Aries, so he doesn't love to be flipped around, but, you know, all in all, it's pretty good over here. So what this is not a great energy for is going to tackle new investments, going to get into a legal battle, going to do anything like that. It's not the best energy to start something new, but take Mars backwards. Where do you need to get in contact with your sexuality, your intimacy, your reproductive organs? We've had Saturn over here in your 6th house. Has there been a health challenge that has come up that is somehow deeply connected to this Mars energy? Now, Mars is also the energy of how you're doing things, how you're going about them. So in this 8th house, maybe in partnerships, whether that be with your bank, with the IRS, with your partner, you guys are having to relook at the actions that you're taking, or Mars brings in just new needed actions. I mean, think about it again. If we've, whatever the conception situation is, if the business or the baby or the whatever has come to fruition, we will need different actions. We've got to redo some things, right? I also think that this particular Mars retrograde has so much to do with your identity, that in connection to other people, places, and things, Virgo, this is a phenomenal time for you to relook at who you are, your desires, how you show up in your social circles and in your intimate circles in your life. Because if you're very standoffish, if somehow you have nitpicked yourself into a position of isolation, that may be something that you want to adjust at this time for sure. And it is Mars retrograde. Yes, an ex could try and come back from the past, okay? And just to say this, if somebody shows up in your life during a Mars retrograde and the sex is just so good you can't even believe it, be mindful of super attaching yourself to that person, because sometimes Mars comes out of retrograde and it is really not that good. So I just want to put that out there for you. November 30th, we've got a lunar eclipse that's in Gemini. The 10th house is lit up again, and we're going to have some shifts coming to this particular point. December 14th, we've got a solar eclipse in Sagittarius. These are fresh starts, but they are fresh starts in your career and your home that were really presented to you from that Venus retrograde that happened from May until June. So track it. Follow it back. What did you see? What have you become aware of? Because that will bring the changes that happen here in your home. And some of this, I think, Virgo, has a lot to do with your emotional security and stability as well. You're a whole new person, right? Like, you're a whole nother year and generation older things in your heart and your soul have changed. So I think that this is a wonderful opportunity to re-fall in love with your work and your home life at the end of the year. December 17th, Saturn moves back into Aquarius, and it'll be here for the long haul until 2023. On the 20th, Jupiter moves into Aquarius. So now we've got expansion, our expansion planet, with our structure planet, and they're together in your sixth house. So work and co-workers and independent freelance work that you do, this is phenomenal because you can create a solid structure under yourself. You want to be freelance, you want to be contracted, you want to start your own business, this is a wonderful energy. But I also think it puts you in a position to be very, very serious about your health and really take on anything that shows up at your front door, okay? Now on December 21st, Jupiter and Saturn come together in what we call the Great Conjunction in your sixth house. Now for the world, this is a big energy because Jupiter and Saturn are called the age rulers, and especially as we move towards the age of Aquarius, they're going to set the tone for our political, religious, economic, legal, medical worlds around us, which will force all of us to change. But in the energy of Aquarius, which is very rebellious, it's kind of that outlier, it's like, no, we're going to do this as a group. It's a very socialistic kind of energy, where some of what I think this turning point represents for you is that in the day-to-day living, you cannot just go it alone, right? You are a small piece of a very big whole, but we need you, Virgo. As well, this could really bring things in your health and your attention to health situations to a turning point in some way, shape, or form. But ultimately, this turning point in Great Conjunction is looking to reduce chaos and confusion from your life and bring a lot more harmony. But this is certainly a very big turning point for what you're going to work on for the next, 20 some odd years in your life. All right, my beautiful Virgos. Oh, I wanted to share this with you. Think back to 2012 to 2015 when Uranus and Pluto were dancing together. What was changing for you? What was shifting for you in those years that was very, very significant? This could tie into this Jupiter-Saturn conjunction for you as well as new patterns or things that came up at that time, but you weren't prepared to have them yet, and now they're starting to show up in your day-to-day life. So consider that so you can track it back as well, okay? All right, Virgos, I love you so much. I'm not going to take up any more of your time. I look forward to walking with you in every monthly video, every weekly video, and I will see you very, very, very soon. Bye, guys.